There you go. So there's his navy right there. So let's attack. We're going for the conquest of Bungo. Sound good? And then as soon as we're done with that naval fight, get over here. All right. Let's get to the game here. Hi, chat. Oh, come on now. I better just be bad timing, Green. You're going to start a problem with me, buddy. Disgusting. Provence and Savoy. I'll take a look at him, Sassy. Hey, I'm Miss Victoria. Hi, Victoria. Personal challenge, get a von Habsburg on the Korean throne. Haha. Hey, the gaming master. Grimjaug. That's the rugged, handsome man we all know and love.
It's me. I'm pretty.
At least I think I am. What nation are you going to play 1.31 releases? I'm not sure. Woohoo, we got the wave. That's it. You always get the wave. Got a PU, Ming. No Bulgaria campaign. Hey, Spit It Wolf. Lukey, give us a Chewy Pog, man. Native boy? 1.31. Possibly. I mean, I'm not opposed to the idea of a native. The issue is that I have to consider... So, like, on stream, we'll do whatever we want to. On YouTube, it'll probably have to be something very specific, or else people will not watch it, because the YouTube audience is extremely, extremely fickle. So right now, we're just coring this stuff up. So I think we can unpause here. Hey. Did I really just have my king die, like, instantly? I'm okay with Griscord being in charge, I'll tell you that. Still watching the Prussian game? Hey, that was a good one, too. Peacefully implode Bing. Yeah, we're working on it. Look at that. His mandate's going down. Nice welcome by the game. Hello, welcome. Let's unpause and kill your emperor, literally as soon as you unpause. Seems legit, right? Should probably build, like, another fort up here. So if we build, like, another fort here, because this guy will protect this guy. But this is a grasslands fort, so it's not ideal for us. Strunk Aussie Aboriginal campaign, essentially. Complained endlessly. You have so much content. I know it. But that's the big thing, is you've always got something to go back to. If you ever are bored, and you say, you know what, I haven't... Like, I wonder what Chewie's been up to. You can always check, and you'll find something, I'm sure of it. Ooh, a new Ming Emperor. How's the income looking? Pretty good. Let me see here. Alright, so Cobalt needs to be my heir, and then I owe Disappointed Soup a general as well. Tend to have game issues, game sessions of 5 hours. I'm too afraid to load into a game for fear of a death. Rewatch them sometimes. Even old campaigns? Ah, cheers to that, man. 9 game plays I haven't even seen. Yeah, man. Sounds about right. You got a queen consort? A Timurid, huh? Really? No way. Oirat has a Timurid? How does that work? So does Uzbek. Okay. And Nogai? Why do they all have Timurids? Look at this. Tengri can marry Sunni. Huh. P.U. Oirat. Byzantine videos are so good. Eh, cheers, man. Thank you. Ooh. This, not so good. We're going to go without that one. Griscord's young. We don't have to worry about him dying. I say. Famous last words, right? So, I'm pirating the absolute crap out of these guys for now. I am not going to trade company China because we're going to end up stating it for sure. Is Timmy even still alive? Doesn't look like it. Looks like he got... it does look like he's down here somewhere. But I don't see them on here, right? Oh, yeah. Ooh, waste. Don't think Timmy is alive? Yeah, he is down here. He's occupied by Transoxiana or Corson or somebody down there. But he's there. Only religion that can marry outside their group is Christians. Yeah, I was going to say, most pagans and non-Christians can marry outside of their group. That is correct to my understanding as well. Playing England to GB. When I end Roma, will I consider playing? I already have a England campaign on my YouTube channel. Take a look. I did an Anglophile run, and it was a lot of fun. I had a good time. Transoxiana, the Noon Tibrids. Had to go and identify someone from a police lineup. They had 5 guys in a row, and they asked me, "Is this the man who mugged you here? If so, which man mugged you?" I responded, Yeah, man, mugged me. Yamana. There we go. I got that one. Took me a second. Hey, Saranoska. How you doing, brother? I recognize you, dude. I know who you are, you filthy Zedmane. Need another world conquest? Ugh. Maybe. Maybe after I finish being addicted to Minecraft. Pirate of Isle of Man. Was fun. 5 degrees Celsius outside and everyone is wearing pretty much nothing. Hello, I just came here. How you doing? I'm doing wonderful, Silver. How are you? Hope you're doing well, dude. Hope you're having a wonderful day. You absolute legend, you. So we have... Let's take a look at our latent goods and see if we need to be worrying about any of this. Jewelry? Jewelry? Well, obviously, we need jewelry. Look at this. Admin efficiency, 5%. Entirely for free, essentially. And we have bronze now, right? Down here. Is this bronze? So we can now get cannon bonus versus fort as well. Very good. Let's do it. So what we want to do is we want to build that in a province where we have a lot of dev. That's not producing a trade good that's like worth a lot of money, right? Not a lot of dev there. This one here. This is the one. So we're going to build cannons here in Huangzhou. What's up, peoples? What's up, Kauranga? How does woodworking increase governing cap? I don't know, but it does, apparently. Speaking of, let's get a couple of latent goods in here. We're steering most of this trade over here, so, and we're the primary collector over here, so it should be good for us. All these latent goods is definitely going to be a good thing. Now, these Ming separatists are definitely going to pop in Beijing. Oh, maybe they didn't. Sounds good to me. Let's get a general over here. Do not actually know. Just a guess. Max production. About 220. No way, Rory. You got it up and running? Make sure you take a look at our fuels. You'll have to go to the end and check it. Wow, we are taking way too much attrition over here. Let's get those guys split. Actually, let's get these guys over here. Then they won't take attrition. Just kidding, they still will. Get them home so they won't take as much attrition so we can actually recruit. It's insane. We need to start selling power to people. We give them a flux plug. Just put a flux plug on their stuff. Haven't even got it running yet. Want to build a boiler too to keep it somewhat efficient. Gotcha. Hey, look at that. We're now admin efficiency +5 for trading in jewelry. And an admin free policy we lose, but that's fine. I don't care. Missed my highlighted message? Sauron Ska? Like the Dark Lord from Lord of the Rings? Ska? The music genre? Cool. What's up, Arrow? Sorry I missed your message too. Man, I missed a couple of them. Why can't you hear the pterodactyl go to the bathroom? The pee is silent. Got him. That's a good one. Nice Twitch stream choice. People don't play Korea much, so it's very original. Cheers. What's up, Bart? How you doing, buddy? Hope you lads are all doing well. Right. Base production, of course. Always production. So as soon as we're done with this guy, we need... So let's take a look here. I think it's 5 development in our bronze province. Oh, nope. We can do it right now. So now take a look at this. This guy will switch to cannons. And we are now producing in cannons. Free stab as well. Heck yeah, bro. And now take a look. It should pop next month. Artillery bonus versus forts. Ship attrition? Yeah, good call. Definitely should pull my ships in here. Too many people out at sea. Good observation. Thank you, thank you. Let's get these guys in as well. Lots of heavies out. That's the major one. There we go. Do we want to take this? I don't think so. I think I'd rather do some dev. So let's do some dev over here. Oh, we already got that dev'd up a lot. Let's put this on development. Dev it up a bit more. Because the autonomy is so high, but it'll go back down over time. Look how expensive these trade goods are. Yeah, being ahead on admin and diplo, it's like, we might as well do this. And then if we can do a little bit of this, we definitely want to as well. Looks like we can't do it for most of our provinces, but I'll do it for a couple of them at least. Cheaper to dev production in the future. There we go. Looks like I can build another one of these. Probably not super worth. We could do some mining though. Why don't we do some mining in a province like over here in our lumber province? Since we have. So, have you guys done any mining yet? Renaissance style in Korea? Gundam style. A hydration, of course. Olillan. Is it worth moving your admiral to the privateer fleet? Yeah, probably. I haven't really... Yeah, we'll do it. It doesn't hurt anything. Let's also state this all up as well. Welcome, everybody. Thanks for the follows today, too. Glad to have you guys all here. Took my mom out to eat last year before COVID. Wanted to try something new, so I asked her, what about Tsushima? Sushi, ma. Ahaha. Stretch.
What do you guys all have going on this weekend? Anything fun planned? It is Saturday. Weather's pretty good here in Nashville, too.
I'm hoping to get out and do something fun. I'll stay up Taiwan. Why not? Being ahead on admin, I don't feel too guilty about it. Working. Lockdown is pretty fun. Well, you could come to rural America where they're not like that. Where life is literally normal. Aunt and uncle coming over from India. Cool, man. Yeah, I'm sure it'll be good to see family for sure. I'm going to lose tax. I don't care about tax at all. You're Indian, by the way? Very cool. I am not Indian, if you can't tell. Ooh, a Noba from the So family. A 135. I'll pass for now. Are you from India? There's four people from down under in chat. You guys are crazy. Wish I could hang out with my friends at the bar. No, I'm just kidding. The gaming master. Gonna be starting PT, recovering a shoulder surgery. What happened to you, Grim? Let's do some mining. So there's a 30% chance it succeeds. On success chance, we get copper, tin, iron, lead, or gold. So let's do it. Let's build a couple of them in like the lesser important provinces. I'll try it in the copper provinces as well. Like these two guys here. See how it goes. Start mining operations on success. So cost me diplo, but it's fine. Oh, wait, what? So this one mining operation failed already. What? Did I just lose my money? Looks like I just lost my money. It tore your rotator cuff? Ugh. It looks like it just, like, took my money. Yeah, don't do more than one at the same time, apparently, is the rule. So, hey, we got copper. Cool. So that means once we get zinc... We can convert that copper to bronze, or to brass, rather, right? I'm not Indian. Nani? So, do we have zinc? Where can we find some zinc? We do have zinc. Let's go. Let's go, chat. So all we do is dev that up a bit. And then we can build this guy. Yes, let's go. That's awesome. Posture check. Yes, sir. Everybody sit up straight. Very important. Mind your spine. That's so cool, man. So we'll be able to convert this copper that we just got mined up into brass. The goals for this campaign? Having fun and exploring some missions expanded stuff. That's mostly it. Trying to ideas expanded. I started Sicily's game. Really enjoying it. Cheers to that, Silver. Yeah, I'm really having a lot of fun with this one as well. Sure, dude. So it looks like Ming not doing too well. Somehow they got a bunch of mandate. I don't know how. It's rival Ming for obvious reasons. And it's nice because since we're privateering him, we get a little bit of extra PP from it. So let's also make sure that we scornfully insult these guys. That way we can keep our PP above 50 for extra mana. Another content creator holy war? Possibly. It's been, there's been, you know, talks behind the scenes, but nothing concrete as of right now. AI beneficial events? What do you mean? Not enjoying, though, is that my Ottomans are getting smarter. Uh-oh. How so? Stiopa isn't going to be around today, but he told me that Ottomans are stronger in this pack. So we are trading. Nice. Since we've produced all these latent goods already, we're getting a lot of benefits from it. Look at this. We have 50% of the trade, 50% of the trade. And as we get more trade, our income will actually go up even more. As we get more trade power over here. Which realistically, we should probably attack these guys sometime soon, huh? I suppose there's no reason not to do it literally right now. Let's get these guys over here. Does he have any allies that I care about? Nope, it's really just us versus him and his vassals. They attack my allied Venice. Allies always truce when I want to spank them. Oh yeah, I can't call venison.
Do it! Just do it!
Just do it. We'll do it. We'll do it. I'm going to wait. The yearly tick, we're going to take that. Definitely take the government reform progress. Ew, bro, what? No, I'm going into this war with negative prestige. I don't care, that's trash. Give me a ruler who's not literal poo-poo, man. Hey, free mana though, I'll take that. Go commit die, heir. Us, heir? Never heard of him. So, let's attack you on the monthly tick here.
Oof.
Why you never unify Nippon? Need our waifus? I'll do what I can here. Hey, we got this mission done here for colonizing Alaska. Gina Conquistador. Get down to California. I think we'll just make our way down the coast. I'm in no rush. Yeah, why is their mandate? Their mandate has gone up. That's really weird, actually, but it is what it is. I'll lose more prestige. I don't care. At this point, it doesn't mean anything to me. So let's make sure that we can catch his fleets out so he doesn't kill this little two stat, because that's always like the most annoying thing that happens. Is that as soon as you declare the war? There you go. So there's his navy right there. So let's attack. We're going for the conquest of Bungo. Sound good? And then, as soon as we're done with that naval fight, get over here. And of course, we got to blockade these guys right here. And blockade these guys over here. Ah, that fort zone of control is jacking us up. All right, that's fine. Take a look here, though. We need two more artillery, and we can actually get the extra bonus that we get from our trade good. So we're going to do that. Enrique and Henry VI, honoring your current Byzantium campaign. Has tilted you so hard, they allied a gigantic Timurids after the second war. Oof, yeah, it's rough. Starts at zero siege. Zero, I know, isn't that so good? We have good siege ability as well, apparently. Why, I have no idea, but we do. I'm not gonna ask questions. So this stack is hiding right there. I don't feel like losing. So let's get these guys over here as well. All right, we won. Very good. Scorch it just in case he wants to do... No way. This bastard really just wiped those two cannons that I just built. All right, that was smart. I mean, I can't be upset about it. He just outplayed me. So let's get these guys down here and wipe them, of course. And then carpet siege down this island. We're going to end up taking Tsushima as well, since they're pirates. Bye-bye cannons. Yeah, feels bad, man. I guess I kind of asked for it. So in this war, I want all of this. Definitely all of that. And ideally, we take like this half of the strait as well. Gives us another trade. And then we could take like this half of the strait as well. Yeah, we won't even get a coalition. So I think that's the move. That'll give us a lot more trade power. So we'll be able to collect even more money. Because see, we're making 24 ducats even with only 61%. Take Ryukyu. Let me take Ryukyu. Oh, wait, they're not in the war. Rip cannons. Favorite idea group so far? I think engineering might be my favorite idea group. Movement speed, fire damage received, construction, fort defense, dev cost, construction time, or construction cost, land attrition, siege ability, fort maintenance, national garrison, more siege ability, blockade impact on siege, and supply limit, as well as the policies. Let me see here. Which one? Does it say innovative exploration gives trade power? That's fine. This one right here. Construction cost and 15% more siege ability. Innovative and engineering. The home of anime. We have to burn it with fire, of course. Let's get these guys over here. Let's actually have our cannons all up there as well. And then obviously we need to come over here and blockade him for the extra plus one. So we're actually getting plus three. Really strong. And this is blockaded, so they can't even come across the strait. They have to attack me over here. So it's like, as long as we are smart about it, you know, we'll be all right. Consolidate Japan, working on it. Definitely working on it. This is grasslands. I don't want this here. Let's get these guys over here. They want to have a standoff. This is hills, so I'm actually totally down to let them do this. There you go. No river crossings? Doesn't look like it. So let's just get our army together and have them bomb these guys. And so I am... Ooh, I'm going to wait until the yearly tick here. That way I can get Miltech a little bit cheaper. So this person's half off for the level 3, so I'll take her. Let's get the discipline guy as well. I don't care about the siege. Like, look at that. No big deal, right? What's up, Draka? How you doing? How is the tech and institution? We spawned colonialism. So we're good on institution. Tech, we are also tied with Ming. So we're doing really good. Yeah, institution, colonialism spawned out here. So hopefully that set Europe back a bit. So I'm going to take this mill tech as well. So these guys are on mill 11. Yeah, they are. So as soon as we go in, we'll have the extra tactics advantage, and I will actually have better infantry as well. So I'm going to let it go a couple more months. Let my infantry get stacked up a bit, because it's like, with this new bonuses, we're going to be way better off than they will be. We should probably build a couple of these guys as well for a little bit more manpower. Huh? Too big of a warmonger to have someone sell institution to. Just gonna sit here and wait for a minute. I'll take the mana. Gun OP, gun tech is OP. Ideal institution goals, oi rot. I know, no kidding. Literally worthless. So let's get over here. As long as we're there after the first of the month, I don't mind. And his morale is way better than mine. And he's like kicking my ass. All right, man. His morale is way better than mine. Holy crap. So let's actually swap this guy out for a mill advisor or a morale advisor then. Samurai strong. Yeah, no kidding. Bushido. All right. Hopefully they don't. Yeah. They also have a better general than I do. Oh, nice. I'll gladly take this guy here. Come on, don't win a 35. Don't do it. Don't do it. Yes, they got a disease outbreak. So let's give me one more month, and on the monthly tick, I'll be getting over there. Hopefully. Very good. Reinforce. And I will also have these guys sortie. Oh, I don't own the province, sadly. Yeah, I don't think I win this fight anyways. My morale is much better than it was, but yeah, their morale is so much better than mine, even with our tactics advantage. That's unfortunate, man. We're actually taking super heavy losses as well. This is fine. It's fine, chat. It's fine. Imagine if Great Britain took Beijing and conquered China in the Opium Wars. Yeah, I guess. It happens. Things like that. So yeah, these guys are taking a bunch of attrition and I'm not. So, you know, it is what it is. The issue is I can't... Just sitting here thinking about how we're going to handle this. Ming is making 7 ducats a month in trade now. We just destroyed them. And their devastation is still pretty bad as well, apparently. Wow, apparently Canton got sacked in a war. So that's good for us. Japan is strong, no kidding. So here's what we're going to do, actually. This is unfortunate. I have to keep an eye on this. Okay, good. This is what I want. I want them to cross this strait, but not this one. So as long as these guys will be there on the 25th, and I want these guys to come out on like... Very good. So pull these guys in here. Unworthy assistance, huh? Now, I don't want them to actually get across, so let's pull out here so they can't get across. Put these guys back in C. They'll try to flee. Pull them back out. Pull these guys here. There we go. So now, hopefully, they only march like... Okay, this is fine as well. 8th, 9th. So... Let's scorch this province here. That way, if they want to walk across, we'll get there before them. That's the important thing. See, they'll be there on the 7th, and we could be there on the 6th. So we will. They'll take the straight crossing into the woods. And then if they try to reinforce, we just don't let them. There you go. And then we stack wipe his army there. There we go. Yeah, this is much better. Cool. Same thing over here. Get over there. Beat up on them. As soon as they try to flee, we just stack wiped them outright. Cool. So now, just like that, he's lost 77,000 men. Very good. Taking a break from your run while I got coalition without a coalition. AKA me playing Burgundy, getting a PU war on Castile, and both England and France try to enforce peace on you. Isolate him in the southern island. There you go. Much better, though. How about that, chat? I would say that we are we made a pretty good go at it. So let's have these guys like detach the cav, detach like half their infantry, do something like that, so we're not losing a ton of men for no reason to attrition. Take this one back here. Izumo. I'll take these techs whenever they're cheaper. No reason to take them ahead of time. We don't really benefit from it. Hate it when 130,000 troops enter and already won war. Enforced peace is a very frustrating mechanic. Infuriating, actually. I totally understand. I sympathize with that big time. Let's get our admiral over here and have these guys join in on this fight over here. And let's go take Kyoto. And these guys over here. No big deal. Look at this. We're sieging Kyoto down. We got a wall breach, bro. Oh, they're coming for it. They want that hills fort back. Let's block these guys from going that way. That'd be good. There we go. We took Kyoto. Cool. So this is the piece I want. No coalition will form. It's going to cost us a lot of admin, but we're ahead on admin tech, and we'll be able to take it still quite about, probably right on time. And I can also take all of his money, so why not, of course. That's important for all, and there you go. How about it? These guys over here, and does Korea have Admiral Yi event? I'm not sure. What about Master Yi?
Don't let your pride blind you.
Not, bro, when you put the periods in between the words without the space, it looks so weird. Like, post it as a link. Not when you use it, then it's OP. Hey, what's up, TM in your? I hope TM in your ear. I hope you're doing well, dude. Are you the TM or are you a different TM? Are you just a TM who's hanging out right now, or are you TM as in Toby? Yeah. PG-13 TM. Glad to have you, dude. I saw that you had left the Discord again. Hope everything's going well for you. Hope that you're doing all right. PG-13, baby. Always PG-13. Take tech. Yeah. Not bad, right? Get these guys down here. Fight these rebels. Fat-fingered period instead of the space key, way too much. Just mobile pains. Oh yeah, I can understand that one big time. Let's put this guy over here as well. Root out corruption. We're making big money. We also need to buy down our inflation. Now you're in the Discord? Okay, cool. Yeah, I'd seen that somebody named TM had rejoined, but I just keep track of who's in and who's out, you know. Just grew so big. Don't have the overview. True. Suffering from success. Having a Discord that's as big as ours is, I do have a hard time keeping track of people sometimes. Let's convert some rebels here, or some vassals, some people here. I am a rich boy. Feels good, right? Give these guys over here. The only reason we're having unrest is because we're very overextended right now. We're ahead, so I suppose we can accept this culture here. Switch this general out because you can't suppress rebels with conquistadors. There we go. Now we have the source of zinc here. I forgot about this. So then this guy right here will change to brass. Plum rain. Low legitimacy, negative prestige. Yeah, it feels bad, man. Hey, how about that? How about I just buy some prestige and legitimacy? Why did our legitimacy even go down? Must have been an event, I assume. So now we have brass, which is going to give us advisor cost 10%. And then once we get to admin 23, we can get tech cost 5%. Pretty good. Explore America with your conquistador or not. I honestly don't care at all about it. So see a new streaming setup. Hey, yeah. Yeah. I mean, it's the same setup. I just moved my camera over a little bit and put some wallpaper up, but I think it looks nice too. I appreciate it. Hey, cheaper advisors is always nice. That's 10% more money that we wouldn't have before from advisors. As we buy down our inflation as well, that will be pretty good. Overextension, give me admin points. Sounds good to me. So we have lots of manpower and let's do some dev down here, right? Probably should. Let's dev this here. Do we have prosperity? We do. Heck yeah. Let's dev like right here. This is mountains, but I'm still going to dev a little bit of production into it anyways. There we go. That'll help out our manpower as well. Big time. What generates all that inflation? It's the silver mine right here. Yeah, we have it devved up quite a bit as well. We actually have a lot of metals now, but the jewelry is a big one. Look at this income. 5 trade with lots of production going on to it. Name placement is terrible. I kind of like it. Don't you like it? Map looks like EU4 starting date. This map looks like EU4's starting date, does it? How does it feel to beat Columbus and be the Eastern Portugal? Be really rich by the 1600s? Oh yeah, we're already rich. The map behind you? Oh, yeah, it is. It is the EU4 starting date. It's really cool. Here. I'm gonna end up having to rehang it, but take a look. See? You can see Lithuania, Poland. I see like the HRE, France with all of its tributaries, the auto blob. Really cool, right? Yeah, it's on Etsy. I don't have a... I keep on planning to make a command for it, and I still haven't gotten around to it. But if you just Google, like, map of Europe 1444, it'll be the first one to come up. It's really cool. I definitely recommend checking it out. Thuringia. No Thuringia dong on the map. 9 out of 10. It looks like 1444 because it is 1444. Yeah, I need to make a map command. I'll shill for that map anytime. I think that is like one of the coolest things. Ooh, nice. So, let's build a couple of these boys. Make sure we're getting some attrition in these sea tiles. Ooh. Oof. If anybody wants to blockade me, they can certainly try. At their detriment. Does that touch that sea tile? I don't know. Maybe. Probably not, though. Put that guy there. Invest your country's money into cyberdongs? What about cyberdongs? Lots of rebels that are looking to pop down here. Let's hope not. So, what other things do we have? Do we have lead? We have lead. Do we need lead for any latent goods? We could get some discipline. Miltech 15. So, we're a little off from that. But we'll be able to get some discipline from our lead province here. That'll be really good. Be worth a fortune in 500 years. Cyberdong increases manpower by 10% in each province. There you go. As soon as we finish up our coring, our national unrest will go down quite a bit as well. It's a shame that it's not considered... I think we have to harmonize with Shinto, right? Yep, I think that's fine. I'll lose the prestige. I don't care. So that should help our unrest quite a bit. Very good. Will I claim the mandate? I've thought about it. I think we might, just because mandate is kind of fun. A lot of people hate on it. Hey, Ari, hope you're doing well. Time to attack Ming. Is our truce up? Nope, it's not. Hello there. What's up, Dariv? How you doing? I'll lose the prestige. I literally don't care at all. I love the innovativeness. Yes, please. Our innovativeness is really high already. It's almost like we took innovative ideas. Hey. Good evening, my lady. A 412? I don't think so. That sounds literally terrible. Just got back from buying McDonald's hamburger. Decreased our harmony. Feels bad, man. I'm going to keep doing it. We're going to have to let our harmony tick down a bit. It's going to take some time to get this... religion harmonized, but converting provinces and harmonizing with others reduce. Okay, so it's just an overtime thing. So maybe I shouldn't be converting for now. Denmark allied Muscovy in your Lubeck game. That is Sag. So I suppose if there's like a trade good that's bad. Like, look at furs is only 1-2 point. Ooh, this one right here. So, yeah, like this province right here, we have 9 production on this province. We should probably try to convert this province to a better trade good. So if we have the money, we can convert it over to a 551. I'll take that. I can definitely live with that. Your name shall be Cobalt Blah. Slava, I owe you a stretch as well. Fish, easily take down Ming. Do I really already? I wouldn't say easily. It was a bit of a slog, but we did trash his mandate and we took Beijing from him to make it harder for him to get mandate in the future. And he's just been slowly name him Dong. I have to name him after people who have claimed it, of course. Spare mana at the Dev Institution. We'll have it. We'll have plenty of spare mana at the Dev Institution. I don't know where we'll dev it. Probably right here. Oh yeah. Let's actually turn this edict off as well. We don't need this edict over here either. Chat has no one named Dong. Not that I'm aware of. We're just waiting on this building here. It's going to convert that to a better trade good, which is really good for us. I think we're going to have to soak up some of this production from this bronze province again. Oh! Looks like our conquistador died, so we took some unnecessary losses, but that's okay. Looks like both of our generals have died. Just kidding. He's there, apparently. Is the Mandate of Heaven ever worth? Depends. If you have somebody who has one opinion, they will say no. If you have somebody with another opinion, they will say yes. I think it's fine. I think the mandate is a hassle, but it can be very rewarding. Yeah, it can be super good if you want to, but you have to dedicate yourself to it. If you're just trying to conquer China, get rid of it because you don't need it, right? But if you're trying to have fun and play wide while in China and, you know, get into it, that's the way to do it. So check this out. This trade guy is going from 2 up to 4.25 at the cost of a couple of production over here, which we can just, dev up. Not bad. Ooh, sadly. Oof. I did not even see that these guys were not loyal. Or not at 60, but that's okay. More production, of course. So sadly, this province is where we have all this production dev here. And I don't want to sink a lot of production dev into deving the institution. Truce with Ming is over. So it's about that time. He's allied to Japan. Targeting the player. Of course they are. Why wouldn't they? Make CK3 content? Possibly. The Isles is in man for some reason, so I invited them to the trade league. Land needs to be yoinked. So here's how we do this. The hydration, yes, pork chunk. Every time you load a U4, it steals your crown land. Unforgivable. This is gonna be fun. Yeah, we have permanent claims on a bunch of his land as well, so it's really good for us. So here's how we do this. We attack them and just ignore our forts for a moment. I am gonna go with the Take Mandate of Heaven, because what we do have to do is we just have to take Nanjing. And then it's only 50%, right here, 50% aggressive expansion and cost for provinces. Really strong. So all we do is we just come in here, occupy this guy down a bit, and then we're good to go. So Ming Navy. Let's have these guys hunt enemy fleets in the East China Sea. With our flagship, with their movement speed, it should be pretty good. As soon as we siege down Kyoto, we should be able to get him out of the war. And then, you know, I bet these guys have no manpower, so we're good. Oirat will join. Let's go. Yes, Oirat. Ooh, baby. He'll start putting in some work for me. It'll be good. These guys just lost a bunch of ships. Feels good, man. Be back in a bit. You have to clean the house. Have fun, buddy. We'll talk soon. Don't have the points, but check your posture. Thanks. Appreciate you looking out for me. So let's get our cannons up there as well. Thanks, Nako. These guys are going to siege down all that. Don't really care a whole lot. We're making good progress over here. They have not touched my land yet. There you go. They're finally getting onto Beijing. So I'm going to not full state it, but I'm going to put the defensiveness edict on here just so it makes it makes it a little harder for them to siege it down. Their mandate has shot back up from like 20-something. There must be getting a lot of events that's giving them boosts. Von Mino. I just need to piece these guys out. That's all I need to do. So let's get these guys occupied here. There we go. Oh no, they sieged down Hokkaido anyways. As soon as we take all these little provinces out here, I'll be able to piece out these guys. And, I can make them a tributary. I probably just want, like, war reps from them. Yeah, that's fine. Take some money. It's no big deal to me. Get these guys down here and have our ships come down here. Looks like we lost some of our pirate fleet. So that's actually bad because... Oh, never mind. He's still not able to get any trade income. Because apparently they're still pirating even though they're in port. Look at this. Look how many men they have over here. It's crazy. Oirat going to be annoying. What is with this Ming? Look at this. What? They snaked all the way around into Nepal? Ooh, buy a new car? Best of luck. Yeah, man. Have fun. Happy shopping to you, friend. Right, let's get these guys over here. They have not won Beijing yet. If I can get my boys over here together. Ooh, looks like I'm going to fight the Ming Navy here with our superior admiral. Sunk a heavy ship. Very good. We probably need to upgrade some of our ships, so we're going to take a... Ooh. Get these guys over here. This fort protects them right here, so we're good. Let's have these guys brought over here to Gyonan. No, it's fort. It's scorched, so we're good. I will... Of course they popped there. Why wouldn't they? Been listening to you for speed bridging? What is that? Let's get these guys over here. Let's scorch this province so they can't reinforce us quickly. Yes, very good. Easy win. This is grasslands. They'll be there on the 1st, and I'll be there before that. So they'll actually take a river crossing? Nah, no river crossing. A 1-6 general to a 3-4. I think I can live with that. No monthly tick, though, sadly. But a 1-1, we definitely win, especially with lower mandate. Yeah. They're going to take really heavy losses. Looks like they broke off that siege over there, so that's really good for us in Beijing. Easy clap. Bridging fast in Minecraft? Ah. Very good. I have like hundreds of hours of Minecraft. I didn't know what that was. Look how much money we're making in trade. It's crazy. Let's state all this stuff up as well since we're way ahead on admin. No reason not to. That will give us better income as well. And we'll be able to update these centers of trade as well, which will keep even more money in Nippon. Tactic in Minecraft servers to bridge fast. I have stream tomorrow. No, tomorrow is Sunday, and I do not stream on Sundays because Sunday is the Lord's Day. The Aleutian Islands, Alaska. All right, we have a... printing presses here. We have a dude. So let's... This one will actually form our colonial nation, Korean Western Alaska, of course. So these guys have no general. Seems like a good fight for me. Seems like it might be a wipe. Yep, it was a wipe. Very good. I'll scorch this just in case they want to try to do something funky. And let's get over here and siege this down. Let me get my cav off and like half my infantry off. Just to avoid the attrition ticks if possible. Less attrition is good. That extra siege pip is really good for us. Doing Ming a favor of cutting army costs like that? I know. Yeah, it is. That is one way to think about it, honestly. Name a colonial nation after me should be an option. I honestly need to add a lot more of those. Like, I need, like, add an army. Or name an army. Name a navy. I need a bunch of those. Quag has a bunch of really good ones. So in this war, I want to take as much as humanly possible. I want to take everything that I have permanent claims on. And look at that. Only 60 aggressive expansion for 109 overextension. And I'll do it. I'm definitely going to do it. 469. Come on now. So let's upgrade all my ships here and let these guys do that for now. They're taking all this attrition, which is really good for me. Oh, yeah. We definitely need to upgrade our navies here. So we're going to have to come down here and siege his capital because he's got ticking war score from his capital. Do something like this. Have to be keep in mind that these are all infantry, so if they, you know, come in here, they're probably going to beat up on me. It's a lot of admin, but I'm going to say worth for sure. So they're not touching my prosperity. Really. I should have a fort like right here, and that would extend to this. I'm going to do that right now. I'm going to build a fort right here. It's going to extend to this, so if I ever do get blockaded, the prosperity. Name a capital after you. All right, Popeye. Popeye, what would you like it named? I want to die. Declared war on Frisia and they got annexed by somebody else. So Stettin became the war leader and they declared it called in Poland. Zoink, Scoobs. That's a rough one. Mandate going down. Brother, come on now. Oh yeah, I don't need those guys hunting pirates anymore anyways. Let's get these guys over here so they get the extra additional repair ticks. Same with these guys here. Something like that. Rooftop Koreans. Rooftop Koreans. Jimin Town. Let's go with something. Let's go with Jimin Town. Very good. Like that. That is our capital. Our 37 dev capital. How about it? We. The 7 P's roll. What is that? I'm off. Have you obviously got this covered? Dog needs the BP. Yeah, you too, TM. Hope you're doing well, Toby. Take care, buddy. So, I kind of don't. This is fine. This is fine. We're ahead on tech, so it's not a big deal. And they won't actually be disloyal for a long time. I'm actually going to do this. I'm going to try to get the Neo-Confucian Reformers because that will allow me to get a get them loyal. So let's build a dock here because we want to do that anyways, right? There we go. And the extra loot tick is going to help us with a tiny bit of devastation. No matter how small. Get that over here. Your game's over. Ooh, whoa. That is a very large merc stack. That is a 60k merc stack right there. Ming has 42,000 manpower. They have no professionalism, which is good. Mandate is now going to be going down significantly quicker. Scorch's capital, because screw him. Let's get these guys grouped up together. Definitely need to. Merc up, then bankrupt. Yeah, I mean, there's no point in not death warring it. Russell. The yearly tick got me. So let's have these guys go back to hunting pirate or hunting enemy fleets. And have these guys go back to privateering in Beijing. So take a look at how much money they're making when I'm not privateering them. 18. Safe to say, privateering is quite good for us. Lucrative for us, even. So there's no general on this army. I think I'm okay with attacking them. How many cav do you have? What? Why is it showing cav as their icon? I don't know. But yeah, safe to say we're winning that one. Scorch this province, so they're going to be slow to reinforce. Might even wipe themselves. Not bad, huh? How about it, chat? Come on in and wipe out as many of their smaller stacks as possible. That extra 20% movement speed is really clutch for us. Look at that. That was a slaughter. Feels like it, too. So they were making 18 and now they're making 4. So safe to say privateering and occupying the land in their home node. Doing good for us as far as that goes. Oirot, poor guys. They're going to lose that too. Feels bad. Mark those guys in. March those guys in to get instantly wiped. Our manpower took a solid hit there, but I'm okay with it. So same thing. Get you guys out and like half of you guys out there. Don't think Ming is coming back from that one. Yeah. I don't know. Sunk the Ming flagship. Feels good, man. These guys up here to go privateer in Beijing as well. Beijing is now controlled by pirates. Pretty good. Making progress towards synchronizing with Shinto. We had talked about possibly accepting or to be converting to Shinto, but I don't know, man. Well, these guys are attacking me here. All right. Yeah, I don't think so, dude. This thing's a little reckless. Gonna max out on mill here. When does episode come out today? In an hour. Comes out at the same time every day, buddy. 11 p.m. Central Time. Or 11 a.m. Central Time. There we go. I'm not really too worried about devving the institution quite yet. This is farmlands. There is no general unless the teleport went in. And they did not. Very good. So another absolute slaughter for them. They're going to march in this little 2.4 stack. Sounds good. I'll come up here. Take out all the... always take over the small stacks if you can. If you can wipe out a small stack, you should always do it. Shift consolidate. There you go. These guys don't stand a chance. These guys are coming in here. This is more farmlands. We got some rebels popping over in Japan. So we'll peace out pretty soon here. Oh, baby. Shinto gives 5% infantry combat. Yep. Always take your 10 to 1s, in the words of DDR Jake. Wise man indeed. So we need to really get our boys, like, recouped here. We have a better... This guy's got more maneuver. So it means he'll get better reinforcements. Well, all we need to do is occupy this province here. So, Eirat, you're going to need to give me that. Come on, Nat. Are you actually kidding me? All right, guess I'm just going to have to death war this one. Have to wait for Oirot to get full occupied. Cool. Well, I'm out. I'm going to let Oirot get siege down so he'll peace out. I can't be bothered for that. He's really going to occupy provinces. What mod is he using? We are using... It depends. We are using the extended family of mods, if that's what you're referring to. Visual mods or exclamation point mods. I have a pack that I made specifically for that question. Sink his navy. He has no more navy, basically. So let's get these guys over here. What's up, Giovanni? Hey, Jack. Thanks for the 5 months, buddy. Was I a good ruler? The best.
Was I a good ruler, boss man?
You are. You're actually a great ruler. Stab cost, yearly army tradition, and construction. Cobalt is not the best heir, but your seed might be a little weak. I need the synchronization. Yo, I'm insane. Were you not here when we actually rolled you? Oh, get out of here, you jerk. Are you Epic Chad? You can be whatever you want to, man. Yeah, unless Oirot gives me these provinces, I'm not going to peace out. I refuse. Get these guys back over here. Put them in charge because they will get more reinforcement ticks. Maneuver increases how much you reinforce your stacks. So it's a really good modifier to have on a when you're in enemy territory. Also, again... Always take out the smaller stacks if you can. No reason not to. Literally no reason at all. They formed Japan. Very cool. It's a second tag switch in a couple of months. So these guys might reinforce there. What? Just kidding. Monthly tick, monthly tick. Yes, let's go. So they're taking a 28 stack in here. Should be a slaughter. Absolutely. Same thing. Come over here with this general so we get the extra maneuver. Just wipe out all their smaller stacks. Why not, you know? Yeah, it looks like Oirad is actually feeling pretty good about this war. It's fine. The longer we're in this war, the better. Because he's getting more devastation, which is going to tank his mandate even better. Matter of fact, what if I actually took mandate in this war? I kind of don't want to. Because I want to use it to take as much clay as I can. And then... So, let's take a look at what our missions will bring us as far as claims. Oirat has red for every Ming province, so it doesn't... I don't think he'll cede you the province. Yeah, I know. I saw. I mean, I want him to peace out. Like, lose interest and peace out. But it looks like we'll probably get called for peace before then. We'll see here. So... Subjugate the Jerkins. We can do that eventually as well. Secure the sea. So in order to get that, yeah, we're not going to be able to get that. That'll give me permanent claims on a ton of Chinese territory. Set sail in the turtle ship. 20 galleys. Naval tradition of at least 40. Gives me ship durability to the end of the game. Okay. What is our naval tradition? It's really close. All right. So I suppose I should have these guys go back to protecting trade over here in, well, let's protect in Beijing. And let's collect here instead of, we're going to end up just moving some stuff around. So this isn't going to work for now, actually. Let's protect trade in Nippon. That will give us some tradition, right? Now we're losing it faster than we're gaining it. Yeah, okay. So privateering is definitely the way to do it. In Beijing. So I kind of would like to dev it here, but the production is going to be a pain in the booty. Because I don't want this silver production to go too high. Because then our inflation is just going to be, like, ridiculous. But then again, not really, I guess. So, let's, those guys are loyal. Let's put this guy here on this. And then see what we need to do to dev this institution up. Because it'll spread to our capital over here in Jimintown quicker. Back to OPM Lubeck. Reconquest. Well, there you go. Time to dev up printing press. Absolutely. So, I'm going to do these guys first. Because it's cheaper if you dev these guys first. And then, you sink all your points into admin. There we go. There we go, we got it. We might have actually even gone overboard. But even better yet, which is hilarious, we're now going to be producing even more money from the silver mine. Looks like EAC? What? Do we take like a gold province over here that I missed? What? Oh, we have a gold province in the New World. Nice. Be good for our boys over here in Cascadia. Protestant Korea is normal. Oirat has, what am I seeing here? 13 ducats a month in trade? Oh yeah, you're good. So let's come down here, get those guys wiped out on that fort here. Ooh, they're coming in here. Let's catch this 3-stack out here. I'll just keep wiping out his little small stacks. I don't mind. Looks like I lost this guy this yearly. These guys are what? These guys are so cheap. These guys must all be half off. Let's go with inflation. Trade efficiency sounds good. These guys are so cheap. We have minus 62% advisor costs. Holy crap. Be like a newbie idiot. 62? What are you talking about? Oh, how much money we're making? It's pretty good, huh? This is from looting. Oh, no, that's from, oh, no. That's our pirates. Our pirates are making 11 ducats in Beijing. Am I devastating Ming, or what's the point of this war? Well, the point of the war is to take clay, but Oirat came in and took a bunch of, occupies a bunch of territory now. So these guys are, like, beelining it for me, and I don't understand why they won't just, like, go fight, like, go beat up on these guys. Kill their armies, right? There's no point in fighting me. You're not going to win a fight against me. You know? But yeah, I want to tank them as well. I want to just destroy them. So the devastation is... Oh wait, their mandate went up. They keep getting these events that's giving them more mandate, and it's annoying me. Let's car besiege them down. Sadly, it looks like we're going to have to do this in two separate wars, because it does not... We got call for pizza, and it does not look like Oirad is going to be peacing out. Sadly, I shouldn't have called him in. I was thinking he was going to be more of a distraction than anything. But I'm okay with having... Doing, like, just taking what we can down here. And then, it'll make a shorter truce. We won't be as overextended as well. Genghis is trolling us. No kidding. Or, even better yet. Yeah, let's just do this. Let's just 100% him. Well... Yeah, this is fine. Give us whatever you're willing to do. Boom. Oh, how's that name placement, right? Got one of your cores back from another war? Dude, I love that. Presidente, 8 freaking months, bro. You are a legend. Thank you so much. Welcome back, dude. How you doing? I think that that is a fine war. Sadly, they're not connected because Oirad had it all controlled, but gotta love that name placement. Agreed. Yeah, I love it whenever, like, the AI, like, say there's, like, a coalition war going on from somebody that got clay taken from you, and then they have to return it in another war. It's always a good one. So, let's have these guys split and send half over to Japan. Have these guys suppress over here, because they're going to end up happening. Overextension. Just got to core this stuff up as we can. Free admin points. Yes, please. And then we'll full core everything as we can go. I don't care about that. They can be disloyal. It'll only be for a couple months. Doesn't mean anything to me. Suppress rebels here. Yep, they're all Japanese separatists, so it's okay. Sure, man. Let's take a look down here. Ooh. Well, I don't know. So here's the deal. If I want to just not deal with the inflation anymore, I could convert the silver to jewelry, which would give us a lot of money in trade rather than... We're already getting the bonus of producing it or trading in it. So, I don't know. Which idea you pick? We want innovative exploration into engineering. Exploration because we wanted to get... colonization or colonialism. Listening to E4 so relaxing. Cheers, man. You got Silly back or Sele or however. I know the problems you're talking about. Yeah, whenever the AI, like, just gives you cores back in a war for no reason is always so clutch. So we could produce another cannon foundry. We already have two. None of these provinces really appeal to me. Oh, this one here's got 9 production. I'll do it. It's fine. Yeah, let's build it there. Religion, you will I pick? I'm staying Confucian. No reason not to. Confucian is fine. How is our... So we're almost up to our governing cap, so let's get to work on some of these guys here. Start working on these. Bet Europe is a mess right now. I'm excited to see it when the time comes for sure. We will see, we will see. Our buildings are really cheap, what the heck? Again? I literally just had this event. It's fine. I don't care. These guys can stay disloyal as long as they want. Oh, they're not disloyal anymore. Very good. Religion and economic are best couple. Religion and quantity and economic. Yeah, if you want to do the meta. I don't really care about the meta. I'm playing to have fun, not to win. That is essential, in my opinion. Bengal conquering Tibet. Ming was over. Yeah, Ming's over here. Look at this snake from the Ming. Look at this, like, little province isthmus here. It's super funny looking.